Hello, this is Naomi with Sword and Steel, and today I'm going to tell you the biggest mistake people make when buying their first airbrush. When buying your first airbrush, the most common concern people have is the price. There are airbrushes that cost less than $80, and there are airbrushes that cost hundreds of dollars. Well, which one should you choose? Well, if I'm just starting off, I should get a cheaper one just to try it out, right? The problem with this is that not all airbrushes are made equal. Cheap airbrushes are terrible. They are a very bad example of what an airbrush can do for you. In order for an airbrush to operate, it needs to be cleaned and free of clogs. Cheaper airbrushes are harder to clean. An airbrush is supposed to atomize the paint, shooting it out a hole half a millimeter or less in size and with precision. To do that well, you need precision machinery, very good quality tool, and high grade steel. And cheaper airbrushes just don't have that. The rougher surface you'd find in cheaper airbrushes will adhere to the interior, clogging the airbrush more, and you'd have to clean it more. Here we have an Iwata Revolution HP-CR, an excellent starter airbrush. This is a higher quality airbrush that has a 0.5mm nozzle, which is approximately 4 times the size of your average airbrush nozzle, making it much more difficult to clog. When you're new to airbrushing, cleaning and keeping the airbrush from being clogged will be one of your biggest difficulties. This is a test paper done by Quality Control by Iwata with this very airbrush, demonstrating the functionality of the airbrush. This is your quick start guide for how to use your airbrush. The brush itself is a high-grade steel made in Japan. It's very well polished, which avoids the traction I was talking about. It allows paint to flow smoothly through this airbrush. Here is the needle, which is surrounded by a cap or a crown. The crown, you should generally keep the crown in place as it protects the needle, but you can remove it to clean the needle of any dry paint. And I suggest a Q-tip wetted with airbrush cleaner. The lube here can reduce the traction on the needle and can also be used to loosen the trigger if it starts to stick. After many cleanings, the lube already in the trigger might wash out, so keep that in mind and re-lube as needed. This wrench is for removing the nozzle from the brush when you need to clean or unclog your brush. So the answer to my question, what is the biggest mistake people make when buying their first airbrush? The price. Don't cheap out and get a low quality airbrush. It's not worth it. It can't show you what an airbrush can do. Also, try for a larger size nozzle on your airbrush. I wish you the best on your airbrushing adventures. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Bye!